happened with your hair?
Oh, I chopped it off, dude. I cut it. Bald head. Well, I'm not really bald anymore, but not much hair. I'm also wearing my Petoskey Brewery shirt right now. It ran away, bruh. Couldn't handle the beast. Nope, it ran. It was a pussy.
Make him speedrun fast, man.
Aerodynamic. Yeah, my hair was getting in the way. Now I can speedrun faster. Pixel fly by faster than Steam can handle. Pretty much. This game on Steam is so stupidly broken. Tusa, are you part of Lazura, dude? I hate mashing. This actually isn't really helping much.
I'm gonna keep fighting. I'm gonna keep fighting that shit. Keep fighting that shit, hey. Keep fighting that shit, hey.
Barry just ran upstairs. Now he's back downstairs. We outie. Fuck the controller. Stop it. Stop it, controller. You're going like really weird ways. Who runs MMX, a lot of people. Domalix is one that runs MMX. Or Domalix, sorry. Keep getting that confused. Best 100% time. The best 100% time in the world is by Hetfield, and it's like a 35-32. Oh, and Missouri. Probably Demolix with a 35-57. Yeah, probably Demolix. Oh, I think he has like a 35-51 or something. Yeah, 35-51. First try bar. It's always bad to fail that. I don't even know what just happened there. Some graphical moving back and forth. Whiz stuff. Oh, by the way, the world record for this is held by Zero Kindness, and it was a saveless run. Like, he went straight through and had like perfect boss RNG and everything. So like, the only way to basically beat his 235 time or whatever it is to get like perfect RNG through the entire run without saving. Oh, by the way, stairwell story time, so if anyone has a story, go for it, write it in chat. That looming synth. Oh, blah, 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 blah. Hashtag stairwell story time. Why is that? that feel when Mo still hasn't gotten his PB cart and it's been like 3 weeks or some shit like that? Close to a month next week, Jesus. They're taking their sweet ass time with that before they sent it out, jeez. That's funny how you thought they sent it at first, but it was really just like, oh wait, yeah, we still gotta do that, sorry. Fireball, Goldschlager. Jägermeister holds more powers than God himself. Destroy the intruders. How'd you know it was an intruder? It could have been just like the janitor or something. Alright. This part, have to get it first try. We could save like 40 seconds and a lot of time. Like, our time management with grenades and shit. If I do not get caught here. game's amazing casually, but like, I can imagine like overwatching it wouldn't be good. Yeah, baby, first try. Last time I did not get that first try for some reason. Sneaking around on your man? Eddie, have you been sneaking around on your man? You've been stepping out on my door right now. Midgar escape race. It's gonna be fun. That was an odd camera swing. They were pretty good. Should have made a split for the bathroom, so there's like, I guess that's like a 20 minute time in between that split. The bust must plus. Yep.
So you're there now, play a few games.
Jenga?
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Where'd you get that?
3 stars.
Nice. Jenga, bruh. Mama MK, Mama Coyote, just was in the room. Mama Coyote! Turbo emote, bruh. Dude, Mako, we gotta start thinking of some emotes for our channels, dude. Some Frank or Z-Face shit going on. Flush? Always, always. Even Mercy flush it, too, if you want. You flush as you're shitting, so that the smell's never there. Tip. Take that into consideration. Hops off the toilet instead of just steps down. He jumps off the toilet to get down. Took such a big shit out to jump to get off. Blah, 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 blah. If it smells like someone's taco bell there. Right. I'm just trying to think of other funny things. I got the potion for the thieves and whatnot. Right. I'll probably do around like 10 or something to start. I don't really have that much content that needs emote action. I need a drispy one that's different from Bread's. I know the one I want to have too. This whole thing's fucked up. Let's keep going. Bad mode. Run, 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 run as fast as you can. Balls. Do. Looks like he was molesting Hogan. Wait, he wasn't molesting Hogan? I thought he was. That was a good fight. That went really well. I didn't have to heal. Dude! Nice save, bro. I'm already saving time and I haven't even gotten out of Midgar yet. That's like a decent amount of time to be saved. Itchy nose, dude. I tell you what. My movement and mashing skills would be a little bit better. We can save time on the next split too. So there's like 3 minutes buffer time for if I die in the Northern Cavern, so like, I don't feel really bad, because that's 3 minutes buffer time for like later, for late game. So that's really nice to have. Because I was like behind by like 30 seconds last run, last night. Molested! Cloud's gonna molest Tifa in the back. getting some of that TP. Because you get it, because her name is T and P stands for pussy. He's getting some of that TP. You guys get it.
Let's just get some sleep.
That tea, fuck.
Yo, wake up.
This nigga dead. These are my boys. These are the boys we do this shit with. Let's follow R. Okay. That long attack animation, though. Fucking his googly eyed fourth nipple. Perf googly eyed fourth nipple, my bad. Googly eyes for nipples. Shit. Get out of here. Don't do poison. Oh, I didn't want you to do refuse. Fuck. Shit takes a long time. By the way, I'm not gonna heal because a lot of conditions make it so I don't have to heal. My party's fully healed after certain text conditions. I think I actually saved time there, but I didn't gold split, which makes no sense. Maybe? I don't know. Dude, Palmer, what a shit Palmer is. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what's going on. What a shit. That's all you get for free. That's all I'm giving you. Maybe that, but that's about it. Let me just walk around to each one of you, say something evil, and then walk away. I want to control the world and everything around it. So like the stars, the universe, cloud. I mean, Barret likes to take it in the butthole. follow the Kool-Aid trail. The secretary splooge. The secretary is that time of the month. Now we just hold the A button. Chuck them grenades, son. About to keep our job, son. Don't hit red 13. Hit barrel or barrel or something. Nice. Not bad. Not bad at all. Soda Popinski rolling down the street, smoking Indo, sipping on gin and juice. Think of that, please. Fuck up my life. Cool. There's whiskey. Pay it. God damn it. True that, dude. Sipping on gin and juice. Soda Popinski, bro. He's from fucking, whatchamacallit. Mike Tyson's punch. No, I wanted you to be poisoned. We'll try this again, though. Again, dude? Really? Poison this fool. Thank you. Is it fucking bolt? Bio is more. Nice, dude. Bio. That's the way to go. I would use grenades, but I'm really low. The gold splitted roof is, which I didn't think was even possible. I'm gonna save here. Dude, the music's too good. Crazy motorcycle. Three red vipers. RNG, baby, come on. I got an RNG. And a blue. Two reds. Come on, third red. Nice. Typos and motorcycles, mini games, card games on motorcycles. Dude, that's one thing that's good about Midgar is like the music. It has some of the most iconic music like in the beginning of the game. I am professional modus. Wait. Will, are you actually a motorcycler, dude? Jesus, if you're like serious, I didn't mean to be joking. Cause that's badass if you are. My buddy Cody, he rides a motorcycle. He actually just learned how to this last year. Cody Fleming. The hype man. Learned how to ride cycle. Cries in his motorcycle corner. Still go through Cloud's past, at least around the world map, and there's like some new scenery. Not sub 2 this time. It's all good, dude. Thank you. don't even think about doing rolling fire. Thank you. Cloud's next turn, cure all. There we go. Alright, I should be safe. Losing time. Oh shit, I'm mashing for no reason. I thought Cloud wasn't down the rope yet. Shinra's division of highway design must have flunked out of school. Yeah, dude. The split icon, dude. Yep, literally perfect. I was thinking about it today, I'm like, what's a good icon for Cloud's past? And I was like, I know what it could be. It's a chock full of saffron. Yeah, pretty much. Donation incentive? If you actually donate to my channel, I'll go do it. But other than that, no. We ain't got time for that shit. That's like a minute. It's like a minute out of my way, bruh. Gotta keep it orthopedically G-rated. True. That would be our monster, he says. Alright, Sephiroth, do your thing, man. Don't revive me. Awesome. I've had really good luck with that fight in my past runs. Usually, like, he'll turn over and, like, try and revive you and shit, and then the dragon will kill you again. He'll use life 2 again. He'll kill you again. It just gets ridiculous. And that can keep going until the dragon decides to hit Sephiroth. But Sephiroth is just like, fuck Cloud, and decided to go for the dragon instead, which is perfect. Yo, wait a minute, says Barret. This is what happens when I Google too much. Is it porn? If it's porn, I'm gonna have to time you out, bud. I doubt it's porn, though. Oh, okay. Mystery panties. What the hell? Weird. By the way, if anyone wants to post links, make sure to ask me first. Because I've had some people drop some pretty fucking vulgar links in my chat before. Bookmark. Oh, it's fine, Will. Don't worry about it. I trust your judgment to keep things classy and sophisticated. Yeah, they had like a whole, the original Japanese version had a scene where Palmer was getting laid in the Honeybee Inn. And he walks out all like, sucky, 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 and stuff like that. It's really weird. There's also, in the international version of Final Fantasy VII, there's a disc 4. And what that is it just shows, like, it's like the most mid-90s disc you would ever see in your life. it had like all the a bunch of different documents. It's all in Japanese, so you can't ever read it, but there's a bunch of different documents that show like all of the different weapons in a bio and their like their attack levels and stats and stuff, and as well as the armor, all the characters, a bunch of like concept art and stuff, like how the game was supposed to look, all of the or how was they were making it out, how it was supposed to look before they changed it and everything, and how Cloud was like this dude who had a vest on that had like brown, short brown hair, but then once they changed it all around, it was like way, way different. It's really nuts. Zero Kindness actually has that disc, and he did like a 2-hour stream showing off like everything on it, and I was like blown away at like how everything was supposed to look. Like the game was nothing the same. Some of the weapons were the same, like the Buster Sword was a thing, and the Ultima weapon was still a thing, actually. And most of the other weapons and stuff like that, but like the characters, the areas, and even Sephiroth looked a lot different. It was really cool to watch. Yeah, you can trash Materia. You can trash like extra Materia you don't want. Like, say you have a Materia or three or four Materia that are born and you don't want them, you can trash them. Yeah, it's an option in the menu. You can click Materia, rearrange, or arrange, exchange, rearrange, and then, what is it? Then trash. By the way, get ready to spam your fucking, what the hell's his name? Oh, Marilyn Manson's in chat. This is how Marilyn Manson was born. Actually Manson himself. And they just put a bunch of makeup on him, so he looked really white and pale. Shit, dude. I'm actually getting bored sitting here and watching this. Marilyn Manson, boy! Do we still have another 10 fucking minutes, dude? Shit, dude. Oh, this is bad. There was also, like, supposed to be four more materias that were called something. I can't remember what, but they didn't make it in the game, but their program data is still set in the game. Like, they technically are in the game and can be used. The animations are even programmed in. But the materia, they were taken out before the game's release. I forget what they are, too. I think one of them's a magic materia, one of them's a support, one of them's a command. Oh, dude, the test pyramids for the debug room. Yeah, they give you, like, hundreds of thousands of experience in gil and AP. That's actually how this. That's actually the new speedrun route in this game is debug room percent. Really? Damn, dude. It was actually rumored that you could get the tiny Bronco to fly. It's kind of weird. Like, if you did this series of events before Aeris' death, you could get the tiny Bronco to fly. That's all that bunch of bullshit. Or how you could get the third level of the third level high wind, like at the end of the game, like after you beat it, the high wind turns into this more badass looking high wind with like jet boosters and shit. Apparently there was a myth that you could, like, this is all like 1999 2000, these people all on these fucking forums, like, oh yeah, like, you can get the high wind to look like this, or you can get the tiny Bronco to fly, or you can actually get Sephiroth's sword. Which you can, but you can't equip it. You get the Masamune Blade if you... you can get the Masamune Blade if you fight in the special battles at Golden Saucer for long enough. But it's not a weapon, and it's surely not Sephiroth's weapon. And how they programmed in the game the 124th soldier or whatever it is. And they're like, they were telling you in the game, like, if you find them all, you might get something cool. Well, they never finished that side. They never finished that side quest. So, like, there's only two of them in the game. But you can get all 12 by doing the, one of the mini games at Gold Saucer. Which also gives you the, what is it? The parasol weapon for Aerith. That's a really awesome. Jeepers, creepers, where'd you get those peepers? There's a lot of weird, like, a lot of weird myths about this game and what you can do. Like, there was this, like, how to get a silver chocobo and shit like that. Like, what? And there was this huge forum about this. This guy was like, have you guys ever seen the Onyx weapon? Like, another weapon in the game. And he's like, yeah, you have to, like, glitch the game out or do this certain amount of things where you have to breed two gold chocobos together. And you get, like, one out of 284 times or something, you'll get a silver chocobo. And then that chocobo can go underwater in this one spot on the map that, like, no other spot you can go underwater at, but it's just one tile. Like, you can go underwater, and then you're in this small, like, grotto thing in the ocean, and you can fight Onyx Weapon, and it's like a mix of Ruby Weapon and Emerald Weapon and Diamond and Ultima all combined into this really strong boss, and blah, it's like, dude, what? Dude, it's people just talking out of their ass, dude. It's literal garbage coming out of people's mouths. It's really funny garbage, because it's like, that would be actually kind of neat. It's like people that wanted something like that to exist would go all over the internet and just spout bullshit information to people and be like, dude, do you believe me? Like, it's basically what it was. Right, yeah, you can fight the Onyx Weapon, it's fucking awesome, like, I fought it for, and I've never beat him, though, because he's way too hard, like, you're stupid, man. Dude, there's tons of Pokemon myths, dude, there's so many. Like, what is it, White Hand, the Ghost? Dude, my dad works for Nintendo Games. I know. Dude, Onyx Weapon. It's fucking hilarious. But yeah, dude, for like the there was a Pokemon myth. There's actually like a creepypasta based after it, where you can like take a certain amount of steps in the Japanese green version in Lavender Town, like the Ghost Tower. You could take like a certain amount of steps, it's like step countering kinda. You talk to this one witch on like a certain frame or something, and then like game like goes black and teleports you to the secret top tower. That apparently you fight this ghost that was only in the Japanese green version called White Hand. And if you lose the fight, White Hand like eats you. And you literally, like, see this picture of, like, this ghost, like, eating Ash alive or some shit like that. It was so weird. Really odd. The ghost Pokemon. Jeepers, creepers, where'd you get those creepers? Should have picked it. Alright, let's go. Because that would have gone a lot faster. Jeepers, creepers, where'd you get those beepers? Yeah, like all the myths. Like Cubone wears its mother's skull. I'm like, what about Marowak then? Is that the same thing? Is Marowak its mother? Kind of weird. Oh shit. Like, what the fuck is that anyway? Oh, my stomach's starting to gurgle. That means I'm nervous. You know what that means. Nervous. Really nervous. Nice, boys. That was a flawless Midgar, or a flawless Midgar Zalem skip, dude. That was literally perfect. Are real. Massive hype on Snake Skip. Yeah, that was pretty good. I used to play this game. I was like in Midgar, like still at around 3 hours or so. Like it took me like 4 hours to get out of Midgar when I was like younger. Even like a few years ago, before I learned anything about like really what went into being fast in this game, it took me like 4 hours to get out of Midgar, and now I'm like at Junin in like 2.5. It's crazy. Come on, get in a fight, please. That's up for fucking ever.
Nice. That was a good encounter. I can save time on the Yuffie Warp too. Shit. That's awesome. Thanks, dude. Alright, we need to get a first try escape. If we don't, it's fine because I have like 4 minutes of buffer, but like, it would be really nice.